Hello everyone, this is Direwolf 20 and welcome to episode 88 of Direwolf 20's server play series. Hanging out with Soren today. Got some mod updates, including Super Circuit Maker. Soren.
Hello.
You know I'm gonna come over to your base and play with Super Circuit Maker with you, right?
Yeah.
That's what's gonna happen downstairs. In a minute. So yeah, there's a lot of new stuff with Super Circuit Maker that I want to play with. So we're probably gonna be playing with that a little bit today. I don't know that I have a clear goal other than playing with Super Circuit Maker. So I thought I had redstone circuits. Yeah, I do. I've got some circuits. I've got some tiny redstone. I've got some torches. I'm probably going to want levers. That'll be good. A stack will do. So I probably want an Ender Pulsar and a Quartz Resonator. Do we not have any quartz? We might have quartz down here. See, I thought we had quartz. So, when did you steal all my quartz?
No.
I don't believe you.
All your quartz? No. Let's see. Quartz. I have 390 ore, if you need some.
Nah, I'll be alright.
I've been going to Sagnol to get more quartz.
Will you just get it from the Nether, or is there some place you can get it from? So, we're definitely going to want a miniature lamp. And I'm going to want to make some of these tiny plates. Probably at least a couple. And with those, I'm going to want to make... So I just need a palette, right, to do that stuff, and a paintbrush? Is that what I need?
Palette and paintbrush, and you craft it together.
You craft them together? Oh, so I need a palette and brush to actually do stuff.
Yeah. And mine seemed to have disappeared. I'll remake it.
Yeah, I haven't played with this part of the mod yet.
So if you hold Alt when it's in your hand, it'll actually change the color.
Oh, that's cool.
And if you put it in your offhand when you're placing wires, it should, in theory, color the cable as you place it down.
Yep. Nice. I like that. Now, do I need a special type of wire for it to be colored or no?
No.
So I just still use the tiny
the
pile of redstone.
All the wires are inherently gray.
All right. So tiny pile of redstone still.
Yes. And if you... if you come down to my base.
I will be there in a bit. I need to finish making the ingredients that I'm going to need for this stuff. Because I do need tiny bundled wire, right?
Yes.
I don't know if I'm going to be doing any three-dimensional stuff, because I'm not good with that yet. But we'll get to that maybe. That's tiny cool. Segmented lamp? What's that do?
It's basically the 7-segment lamp that you'd see in a car.
Okay.
It's the clock or an LED screen.
Aha. So I'm super, by the way, excited about adders. Like, that's exciting to me.
Yeah. Constant, which is cool.
Yeah, right? Constant is just add a redstone torch to any one of those. Cool. So I've got that. Component tray, I guess I don't need yet. I've got myself a screwdriver. I want my monocle. Oh, and I want to check out blueprints. That's definitely a thing that we're going to need to check out.
Display driver coming soon.
So yeah, I'm going to come to your base and hang out a little bit. What's the one that works like... He said he added something that works like a comparator. Do you know what it is?
I'm looking now. See if there's anything. Let me just try placing a comparator. Probably not. But...
Which one? Who, what now?
I didn't see a new tile. I think it might just be input. inventory scanner. Oh, recipe.
Tiny dust chest. Tiny dust chest.
Cool.
Three tiny plates on the bottom. Oh yeah, it does not have a model yet. It's the default texture, the purple and black cubes. But this thing works like a comparator, which is cool.
I like seeing the missing texture on the tile.
Right? Dude, I'm excited about this a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. Because he added analog support. Analog support!
I know, I talked about this a long time. He's like, I need this. It's like, maybe. I need it.
Dude, analog support? Absolutely needed. 100%. 100%. Because now I can manipulate these things that I have over here that are doing things that I don't need to do anymore. And I'm super excited to be able to do that. All right, where are you at? Are you in your new base?
Just go down to my tunnel. Yeah, you'll find me pretty easily.
Yeah.
There's no comparison. Let's see. I guess we can make a comparison.
Yeah, I like your super circuit maker room.
Yeah, I was hoping to have these users underneath so you just like flip a switch and it clears all of them, but that doesn't. But I'll move this middle circuit so you can actually work around.
Cool. What did you make your chiseled rock and stone out of? What's the things on the side here?
It's just flat colored blocks, so it's gray.
Yeah, but how? Like, what's moving? Flowing thing. What are the things that are moving?
Psi. It's a psi floating plate or something. So you don't have, yeah, I have one of these.
Oh. Dark psi metal flow plate? Gotcha. Cool. Alright. So I'm going to play with this stuff a little bit away from you, because I don't want to break anything you're doing. My biggest problem is knowing what to use it for. I know it's cool, but I need to come up with something to use it for. Comparison would be subtraction and signal overdriving. Neat. So the first thing I want to play with is the adder and subtractor bits, because that sounds awesome.
Yeah.
Because I've wanted stuff that makes that easier for, like, pretty much ever. You know what I probably want? Is some actual, like, regular redstone. So let's see if Soren's got some of that. He does. What's happening to your system, buddy?
I don't know. Like, power just started dying completely.
So if we had a redstone signal going in and out, and we had a lever... And then we had tiny redstone, like this.
I had to toggle my circuit back on.
Well, that's neat. That almost worked. Okay.
We should be good.
Oh, he added rotating. Nice.
Yeah.
That's cool. So this is power 15, and this is power 15, right? So now... I assume this is correct. So I have to figure out how subtractors work, apparently. Because they're not as easy as I thought they would be.
Hello. I cannot be too loud.
That's okay.
My dad is in the room next to mine, so
no worries.
I'm just going to be typing.
What do I need to do with subtractors to make them work?
Have two.
You have to basically taking the number you subtract from. That one is connected to the side with the line. The other ones subtract from that number, and you can take an output from any other side.
Ah, gotcha. So for that, I would want a constant.
Probably, yeah. Also note that the inventory scanner reads a signal from 0 to 255.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it multiplies the signal by 17, so you probably want to divide it by 17 first, then you can do the normal comparison.
Right. I'm just trying to get the basics working. Multiply by 7. So the side with the minus, or the subtractor, the side with the line is where the constant should be?
That's where the number you want to subtract from is. Any other side is the number you subtract from that, and any of those sides can also be an output.
So like this, I would think, but let's see.
The side with the line is the big number.
Yeah.
Is there anything that I can use that tells what the signal is on a certain line other than glowing redstone?
Not yet, but I want to add something, yes. I want to add some kind of, I don't know, a multimeter or something like that, that you can just set up a component and it has a kind of tiny sign on top or something like that.
And do you have a pass-through lamp at all?
I do not, no.
Okay, so everything coming in is multiplied by 17. So if I'm putting a default redstone signal in, it turns into 255 when it shows up, right?
Yep.
Okay. So in that case, I'm going to want to divide by 17. And then this should behave itself.
Yep. Also, Soren, you can now actually use the screwdriver to mass destroy components, which wasn't a thing before, and it's now working fine.
Mass destruction.
Also, Dire, note that in the components that have time, you can do the shift thing you suggested to go from ticks to seconds.
Nice. So this is coming in to there, this is going into there, and that's going. So this should be working, I would think. Right, Soren? Am I doing something wrong here? Division, I presume, works the same way as subtraction, right? With the line?
Yep, exactly the same.
So this should be dividing whatever's coming in by 17. Right?
You have a signal out, too. Yeah, you should have signal right now.
Shouldn't I?
Uh-oh. Emma.
What?
Maybe it's the conversion from 0 to 255 to 0 to 15.
Back to 16. So don't divide for a second.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's the connection from the circuit to the physical redstone wire in the world. That's probably what's breaking it.
Is there any way to read the value on the redstone wire itself? Like, to know what
it's at?
Not yet.
Close. Like, I can get you a redstone piece that will actually kind of emit based on. Let's see, here we go. So it's very low right now, but I can't tell you the exact number.
What is that? The glowstone, glowing redstone.
Yeah, it's glowstone, glowing wire.
What's that do? Glowing redstone.
It just changes emission. Just changes color.
Yeah. So if you want to have something that you can monitor more easily, that's basically what you would use.
Gotcha.
Yeah, so if you take out your division for a second.
Do what now?
Take out your division for a second.
Right.
And then put down a wire.
Right.
Yeah. So
the other option is to, instead of dividing in the input, you can multiply what you're subtracting.
So you subtract 16 and
it will be 17 times stronger.
Oh, I gotcha. You don't. Okay, that works. That works.
Yeah.
So, gotcha. Can constants touch the subtractor, or does there have to be a wire between them?
There has to be a wire.
Okay.
Because there's no other way to route signals.
Right.
Upset, Emma! Lights on top of inventory scanners. Don't do anything.
That's interesting. maybe they're configured to only output to the side, but I can tell you that vertical outputs are now a thing. Yes, you can finally do it.
Yeah, we were talking about this yesterday.
Yeah.
So we want to multiply whatever we're subtracting.
Also, I'm surprised you haven't tried the vertical diodes yet.
I asked about the trying to figure that out. So many things at once.
Yeah.
Inventory problems.
Now this is what happens when there's a big update.
I just want you to release them more frequently.
Shush.
So this will be 5. So,
inductive.
I just saw one of my patrons on your stream chat. I should probably get them the version as well.
Oh, so the conductive plates are the diode itself, is it?
Yeah.
Or my sticker card.
Yeah, you need to click them with a screwdriver, and that's just mode.
Yeah, just
default
change.
Is non-conductive. First mode is
bottom to top. Mode doesn't matter to me right now, because I can't tell which mode it's in.
Yep. Right, that's okay. Basically why I'm telling you, like, click it once or click it twice.
I've clicked it eight times,
gonna be,
I think.
There's going to be an icon soon.
So is this set up correctly, Emma?
I'll check. Give me a moment.
Yeah, so...
So shouldn't that be one?
This one can probably tell you.
The other one should be 5. Oh, why? Okay, yeah, that definitely needs. Yeah.
I'm gonna launch my instance.
So just change your values. You can test it.
What? So shouldn't that be doing minus 5 times 17?
Yeah, right? Now it's minus 5 times 17.
Yeah, but it's not. Oh, now. What'd you do?
No, okay, so you have currently 11 and 15. Your resultant's going to be 4. You're subtracting.
Right. I had 5, though, didn't I?
Right, so 15 minus 5.
Should be 10. Now it's working. Okay. It wasn't working a minute ago, I think. It is now, though. Mm-hmm. So that's cool. Okay. Neat. So basically, your wire goes from 0 to 255. Vanilla redstone goes from 0 to 15. So by multiplying whatever you're doing by 17, you get that direct output. But it allows you to do more fine-tuned stuff on the board itself, I guess.
It does.
That's cool.
So things that want to support a signal from 0 to 255, like an inventory that wants to have a more detailed comparator output, they can do that. It's very easy.
So I just shift left click or shift right click a blueprint, and then if I put down another board, it should make the same thing for me, right?
Yeah, it currently does not consume items.
That is awesome.
It's working.
Okay.
No,
it doesn't consume
awesome.
Items, but it's working.
Cheaty as heck.
That's cool though.
Really cheaty.
Well, I mean, it's, you know, the first iteration, right?
Yeah, it's basically.
And you got rotation
something
working,
I
which
tried
is awesome.
Yeah, rotation took me a while, like way longer than I expected. Also, Soren.
What? A second here, Emma.
Huh?
Look at the stream.
Looking at it. Huh? Okay. Yeah, that was the one case I didn't test. I tested like turning on and off the signal and a bunch of other things, but not actually switching modes. That was.
What'd you do, Soren?
I disconnected a wire and the light was stayed on.
Yeah. I'm kind of disappointed because you were so excited about placing circuits on walls. You haven't done it yet.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Because you can do that. Finally.
Well, that's awesome.
Come back down.
It only took me like 4 weeks to do it.
I know. I'm well aware how long it took.
So yeah, SCM in general just got a lot easier.
That's super cool. I wanna play with my stuff a little bit down here. Some of like the automation that I have down here and see if I can't get her going. So there's creepers just chilling around my base. What's up, creepers?
I hear pings, and that's a crash. I'm gonna believe Snorren. Yep.
I'm watching. There we go. What just happened? Oh no! Stop it! Help! Help.
What'd you do?
Help. It's, the blueprint's updating still.
Oh?
MBD's, oh. MBT is changing a lot on the blueprint right now.
The blueprint.
Oh.
Oh.
I hate you.
What'd I do? I clicked it once.
I think it's synced up with that block.
You tried to blueprint something that's very complex?
He's updated his save to a blueprint, this circuit that's changing right now, and I think that's basically updating the blueprint.
Nice. So if I come see this.
Or something like that.
Okay, what does it give me?
Did it calm down, or is
that's
it?
That's really weird.
I fixed it. Okay. Nice. I copied the circuit.
It's really strange. I honestly don't know.
I need to make an energetic generator at some point, just because I would like to build something that looks this cool.
And I'm going to make this much smaller now that we have some of the nuances.
Yeah, now that you have analog, you can do better.
Yeah.
That's awesome. To do.
Also, just so you know, Soren, you may want to, like, take the chance. You can currently place circuits on opposite faces of a block. They do not interact with each other, but you can do it. So that's going to be removed.
So can I put circuits on a corner and they can connect to each other? Is that a thing?
No, not yet.
Okay.
Well, no, actually, not going to happen.
Okay.
Because that would be way too complicated to code.
Fair enough.
Circuits are really only made to go up. So,
I can't place wire on walls.
Yeah, he said that's not in yet.
You can't.
Damn, I can't place the wires on walls.
I know.
Did I tell you about that weird bug I was having with wire, like, being left behind?
You did, yes. Okay. I need to fix that in MC Multipart.
Okay.
Like a tile phantom there?
A pretty big update to MC Multipart.
If you break the block the tile's sitting on, it leaves, like, a ghosted tile entity behind, and you can't place anything in that block space.
Yep. That happens. I think with non-ticking blocks.
Fire redstone signal here. So if I do this correctly, I shouldn't need these super long and complex things. So what I'm going to do is put some items in here for the time being.
Oh, also, drawing straight lines is hopefully coming soon.
Yeah, it's a little harder now, but...
And previews of what you've already placed. Probably also coming.
Right.
Infinite redstone.
Yay. I'm not going to do anything about that.
I don't know what you could do about that.
Probably nothing, but I'm not going to do anything anyway.
It's a feedback loop, so I mean, the person has to handle it when they're making their circuit.
Yeah. But not going to happen, because you're not going to be able to do that anymore.
What?
They intersect. I did the math completely wrong. If you place 5 layers on one circuit and 5 layers on the other, they intersect.
Okay, so we're saying.
So that's not going to work. I may just make them 7 layers because I can.
Yeah, that'd be better.
So
I think 7 layers is a bit overkill.
I do.
I'd be 7 layer cube. Your 7 cubed is actually pretty good size there. You can actually make a nice
it
circuit.
Is.
I assume no circuits within circuits.
Circuits within circuits are not implemented yet, no, but nice. They are mostly done.
Nice.
The complexity calculation system that's already in place, and really, I only need to get the components working, so it shouldn't be too hard.
Works for me.
Also, Dyer, before you make the spotlight, I may want to implement a couple things, maybe fix blueprints, and I need to make a world for you with like a bunch of builds that Soren and I have made, as well as some of my patrons.
Okay.
Because there are some really cool builds that I would like you to see.
Okay, definitely. No, I would like to. Right now, I am... trying to, I think something's not updating. Well, yeah, that or I'm crazy.
That's the bane of a mod developer.
Yeah.
Things not updating.
Yeah. Like, I changed some of the way the circuit worked. Like, I changed the constant value, but the redstone output didn't change along with it. And I think that's what I was having before with Soren.
That's really strange. But that's possible, yes. I'll need to check.
I'm just going to play with this a little bit off camera, guys. We'll be right back.
Constants.
You're having the same problem with constants, Soren? I fixed it. You just have to break and replace the constant on the tile, and it fixes it. But this is totally working now, by the way, guys.
Yeah. I'm actually going to go check yours out because I have to go in like a minute or two.
So we should see this light.
So I'm going to fly over there real quick.
And now that the light's on, no more TNT should be allowed in. Even after these entropies drain. Well, you guys are full, so that's cool. But yeah. So that's actually working the way we would expect. Because this is full. Yeah, this works pretty well now. I'm basically just doing a simple subtractor here, that's all.
Yeah.
But that's pretty neat.
Yeah, that works.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
It's just 15 minus 14. See? 14 times 17, subtract, and this is a comparator.
Basically, the question is, how is Basky handling mana to comparator output?
What's
like
that?
Is 15 the thing is 15, how 14. Is Vasky handling it? Is 15 completely full or is it almost full, like too full?
I think it's completely full.
It's percentage.
Hmm.
Yeah,
then it would probably be good to do 15 minus 13 so that if there's still something going on here, power can go back to the how's it called? I haven't played with Botani in a while.
So basically the way this works is when there's not a redstone signal being applied to the front here, there's a pulsar and then like delays. So it places TNT and then a second later blows up the TNT. And the flowers here absorb the explosion if they don't have mana in them. If they already have mana in them, then they don't absorb the explosion and the explosion destroys the world. So what I'm testing for is two things. One, I'm testing to see if there's mana flowing into the mana pool here, and that's what this mana detector does. It pulses every time a redstone signal or the mana pulse goes through it, it pulses redstone, and that resets your ender pulsar. And then when the mana pool is full, it just keeps a steady redstone signal on to prevent the placing and detonating of TNT.
Interesting.
Yeah. Next up, I want to replace the redstone comparator and repeater over here on this bad boy. Because this should be awesome.
Negative numbers are not currently a thing, apparently.
No. Only 0 to 255, because that's the signal. You can do negative if you have two wires.
So we'll read this, and this temporarily doesn't have a texture, but it will at some point, I presume.
Yep. Soon. Hopefully for their release. Right. Which should also be soon.
Right.
One day!
I wonder if I can get dividing to work now.
Hmm?
Wonder if I can get dividing to work again.
I mean, I got dividing to work. It told me x divided by 0 equals 0. It was amazing.
So you divided by 0? That's the first thing you tried to do?
I did.
Like, the first thing you decided to do while we're playing is, let's see if I can divide by 0.
That was the first thing I decided to do, and it was 0. Emma has redefined math for us.
I mean, I could make it start booping like crazy.
No, I just wanted to turn that. Whatever debug tool you have, that would be amazing. If it just all you... There's
yes. No, it'll actually be, you know, like, the emerald thingy on top of the Sim's head. It'll be something like that, but with an exclamation mark in red or something like that.
Error.
So you can see it directly.
So what this does is it emits a redstone signal of 1 while it's crafting and 2 when it's ready to go. So we basically want to subtract one from it before we feed it into this guy. So you're going to be over here. This is the end result, right? So to subtract one, we need to do basically minus 17, right? So we'll read off this guy, and we're going to also want you to be an output for one. And then we'll have the redstone dust here just to be sure that it's working. And then we want to do minus 17 here so we can run this across, right? And then we can do minus constant 17, and that's pretty much minus 1.
What have you done, Soren?
And that should work. So let me test this in a sec. All right, so let's see. Runes.
Hey, Dire, you want to have a fun one?
In a moment.
Oh, you broke it.
Okay.
So what we should see is this working. So in a second, nice. So why do you have a redstone signal? That doesn't make any sense to me. You should not be on at the moment because this is emitting power of 2. Why are you emitting a power of 2? I thought you'd do power of 1. Oh, it's power of 2 when it's ready.
Yeah.
Right. It's ready already. That's
power of
that's
1
the
before
thing.
It.
So the subtractor...
It would be interesting if it did 1 for I'm ready, and then 2 to 15 to indicate progress.
What I'm going to want to do is know what this is, so we're going to do this.
I think that would be pretty cool.
Explain. Why is that 0?
See, I want that.
I'm super
I want
confused.
That right there. Oh, well.
I have a feeling you're seeing something I'm not. This is
everything?
The new way of updating circuits and making sure they sync.
Okay. So, if I made like the bottom one,
so let's
17,
try mm-hmm.
and the
yeah.
other one beat whatever
it'll,
value
it'll
I
lock it up. Yes.
Yeah.
Coming
yeah.
soon.
Yeah, soon. One day, like 8 weeks from now, because.
Yeah, in RSA3, which will hopefully be tomorrow.
So when this gets all the items it needs, it'll transfer them.
Yeah.
I mean, with the normal scale of things, it seems to be that.
You got updates pretty much daily back in the day.
I know, it was great. I could find bugs for you quickly, and then you could fix them quickly, and then you didn't have all of them to fix at once.
Yeah, and that's what's going to happen from now on.
Okay, Emma, I need you to look at this.
I'm coming.
To catch up with the previous ones.
I don't have that many anymore, so should be okay. Also, I'm coming here and I have to run in just a moment. So let's see. What's going on?
Sorry about the water.
So, see how this is a redstone power of 2? Actually, let me make this a little bit better here. Let's do... I'm going to move this. Where'd my vacuum chest go that was here, by the way? Did that thing just vanish or what? That's fine. All right, I'm going to demonstrate this in a sec. So, you see how... So basically what it should be doing is doing a comparator. It'll be 1 while it's crafting, and it'll be 2 when it's done. Mm. So it basically outputs to the front here, and you'll see it'll actually be red, and it'll be a power of 1. And then over here, I'm subtracting 17, right? So whatever this is, minus 17. So minus 17 is basically like minus 1, right?
Yes.
So that should not power to the mechanical user when it's emitting a redstone signal of 1, correct?
It should not.
Right. And the light should not turn on the miniature lamp over here, right?
It should not.
Okay. So, stand back a little bit, Soren. I don't want you to pick up the items to drop. So, in about a second, it's going to drop items.
That scared me.
Okay. Yeah, explosions are fine.
So, what's weird is that on the right here, the lamp is on, but the redstone signal on the right here is not.
No, because it's just telling you there's a signal on the path, but it could be less than...
There you go. 18. No. Apparently that works.
Less than 16, it'll...
What'd you do?
Not power the redstone.
Oh, you made it 18? 18. Okay.
Yeah. I guess that works.
Explain.
I can't. I really can't.
Okay. Well, as long as you can't. Well, let's see if this works.
I have no clue what's going on, to be honest.
Okay. So now the lamp turned on. The user didn't actually place the item, though. So that's a little bit weird.
No. Mm-hmm. Redstone's not on the side.
Right. Which I don't understand why not.
No, because it's less than 16.
Yeah.
If the value is less than 16, it'll be power 0.
Okay.
If it's above 16, it'll be power 1 or more.
Okay.
Yeah, it rounds down.
So shouldn't it be 2 times 17 minus 8? Okay, so this was...
Plus the derivative of 8x divided by 3 and times the irrational number plus pi. Yes. Actually, why is pi not a component here?
So I had to bring that subtractor down to constant output 1 in order for it to actually do the
thing.
There
you go. No, it should be an actual.
You know what? Yeah, minus 1.
You can work
with. Minus 1 would work, right? Right?
It could. Maybe. Let's just do 17 to be safe. And that should multiply again by 17. So that should be an okay signal.
Yeah. Okay, let's see what happens. I'm trusting you. This is your mod, so. So yeah.
I don't trust myself.
It's outputting a power of 1 right now. It should be outputting 0.
Well, I mean, you put a multiplier there.
Yeah, now it's 2. So yeah, make it...
I'm just making it higher.
Okay.
There you go, now it doesn't work. Good. This is what we wanted, right?
I'm thinking the solution is to make it 1.
This is your fault.
Why is this my fault? What did I do wrong?
A subtraction sign does not have 2 dots.
What?
That's a divide sign, by the way.
Yeah, it's a divide sign.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, maybe that's my problem.
Yeah. I was wondering, Dyer has some math here that's going very complicated, way over what you need.
It looks similar.
I'm sure he has a thought process here.
It looks similar.
At 17, actually at 16 should work.
1 should technically work, right? But I want to see 17 work. Because 17 should work, right? I need more of these things. So, yeah. I'm sure people noticed that. I'm going to get yelled at a lot in the comments.
Yep.
This is why we can't trust Dyer with nice things.
It's true.
Yeah, especially redstone. And especially if it controls TNT.
No. The key word here is wire.
Math.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, hold on.
Oh, by the way, did you know that you can use the acceleration one on the flowers and the spreaders?
That's terrible.
Yes, it is.
It is.
I was playing with that earlier.
You have a piece of tiny redstone in there.
Yeah, now that's what I'm clearing out.
There There we go. That's one. That's zero.
Yep.
Okay. This set to 16 works, and will it do the thing?
Yeah, it's not. It's not doing the thing.
Yeah.
Oh well. Yeah, I guess your option is to do 15.
Yeah, that definitely needs to be changed.
Oh, you did.
Let me break and replace the constant. Not that that's going to be a good thing.
Yeah, maybe a good option.
Hold on. I want to move this.
Oh, no. Yeah, the output from the subtraction is not actually an output.
Gotcha.
That was the issue. That's two now.
So 18 turns it off, 17 is on. Okay.
Yeah, that's one. Okay, that's what you need.
There we go.
There you go.
Sweet.
And now I have to run because...
All right, guys, so I think what we're going to do is wrap up the episode here. But definitely cool. I want to play more of Super Circuit Maker. I just have to come up with some cool stuff to do with it. I'm thinking the Endergenic Generator like Soren has. I want to get into making one of those anyway. And it's a really good use of Super Circuit Maker because it requires a lot of complex redstone circuitry. Like, all of this is actually a functional process, and it's doing what it's supposed to be doing, and that's really cool. And I want one of these that I build.
You should have fun making one of these. I need to get an Ender Pulsar, and then this works.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically. What the fuck?
So cool.
Pulsar?
All right, but we have to go now. So wrapping up point, well past it. Darryl20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Take it easy.